I went through those 10 tests in 3 years. 3 years, all it took. Before God said, all right, it's time, let's go. Now, I pray that's how long. And I served a man named Jim Pointer. I took care of that man, and he would say to me, Benny, why are you doing this? I said, because God is watching, and I want to make sure I prove myself faithful to the Lord. He was a Free Methodist preacher who took me with him. I would go with him everywhere he would preach, and I carried that accordion. It was heavier than me. But I served him, and then he had a stroke, and I even stayed with him then. He died and went to be with the Lord later, and he became a father to me in the spirit. I served that man. I will tell you, I'm standing here and before the God I serve. If Jim was alive today, I would still serve him. Even though I'm in my own ministry, I'd still serve him. Because I don't believe you quit serving. No way. Never. So, warfare will come at you. You'll develop your weapons of war. And there's only one way out of warfare. Walk in the Spirit. Walking in the Spirit defeats every enemy. Number nine. I hope you're learning something. Number nine. Right before God uses you, the last test is your vision. God will test your vision. He will come back to the vision of your life. Nehemiah chapter 1, I'm not going to give you because we're almost out of time. Nehemiah 1, 1 to 11, Nehemiah 2, 1 through 6. We see Nehemiah's vision tested. His vision was to rebuild the walls. His vision was to rebuild the temple. His vision was tested, Michael, to the limit. Enemies arose, tried to stop him from rebuilding. So he would build with one hand, fight with the other. Your vision becomes blurred by girlfriends or friends or people that come in your way that try to steal away what God really wants to do with you. And you got to stick with your vision. And your vision will be tested. Now when you can prove to God that you still hold on to that vision, you're almost there. Your vision will be tested. Write Habakkuk 2 verse 1 through 3 talks about the vision. What you must do with the vision. In fact, can I give it to you quickly? I said, can I give it to you quickly? Okay, let's go to Habakkuk, please, Mr. Brock. You turn to Habakkuk chapter 2. Read for me verse 1, 2, and 3, and I'll tell the people right now what they must do with this vision. Okay, that's Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 1, 2, and 3.
I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what I shall answer when I am reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision.
Now, the first thing you do when your vision is retested, rewrite it down. Here's what God has called me to do. Because God has targeted your life for a ministry of your own. That's the vision for your life. In the meantime, you've been called to serve another man. You're walking on that road, and the last thing God will do before your own ministry is birthed is your vision will be tested. You write it down. Number two.
Make it plain upon
make
tables.
Make it plain. You make it plain means you rehearse it to yourself to make sure you understand the vision for your life. It is not foggy, it is plain, it is simple, you target it. Number three.
That he may run that readeth it.
Now, the third thing you do to see a vision fulfilled is go after it. But these are the things you do when you refocus the vision. Your vision will be attacked. Tested. That's the last thing that will happen before God promotes you. The minute you refocus on that vision, write it down, make it clear, go for it. Now comes the last and final test. You will be tested. And here's what I call this test. God will test your ability in promoting you. In other words, it's a promotion test. He'll see, can this man handle exaltation? Can he handle promotion? Can he handle it when he gets on the platform and people start clapping? Because the man of God, like a bunkie, may have you minister one day. That's the promotion test. That's saying to you, you've proven yourself faithful to me, such and such. Come preach a message. Suddenly, God will watch. Let's see how he handles that. Will he become proud, arrogant? Will he think to himself, I can replace Bunker now, just push him out of the way? God will see that in you. He'll test your heart. Remember I gave you last night. God tests the hearts. Proverbs 23:26 says, give him your heart, he'll test it. He'll ponder the heart, he'll search the heart. Jeremiah 7:17 tells us, God searches the hearts. Now, when that time for promotion comes, God will see how you handle it. My promotion moment came. I'll never forget it as long as I live. I was in Toronto, Canada, at a little Methodist church outside Toronto. A fella who was a missionary in Honduras asked me to come with him. He was preaching on a Sunday morning. That was the first time ever I was behind a pulpit. I wasn't in the ministry yet. I wasn't in a healing ministry yet. I had no ministry. I was still serving Jim Pointer. And this dear precious missionary said, Benny, come up and speak. First of all, I used to stutter, so I couldn't talk anyways, which was a marvelous blessing at that moment. I just stood there, and amazingly, I was able to pray a very short prayer and went and sat down. And he said, but I wanted you to minister. What I said to him, I said, this is not my time. This is your service. I respect your office. I cannot take from you what doesn't belong to me. And I believe God looked at it and said, good boy. Because if I stepped in and pushed him out and began to preach and thought it was my service, I'll just be canceled out of the way. Be careful how you handle that last moment. That test, I'm going to say something that may not be understood, but I'll say it. God is very sensitive about that. Don't dishonor his servant. Don't dishonor his servant by taking away from him his mantle before he gives it to you. Remember that Elijah's mantle fell from the chariot. Elisha didn't say to him, give it to me before you go. He would have lost his office. Did you hear what I just said? Elijah was on his way to heaven. And Elisha said, give me, I want a double portion. Now some people will say, wait, Elijah, don't go yet before I get the mantle now, please. Had Elisha asked Elijah for the mantle that was on his body, he would have been dismissed from the call. But while the chariot was up, the mantle was given to him by itself. God will give you the mantle. You won't have to pull it off the man's shoulder. Did you hear that? That's called the promotion test. He'll promote you. He'll give you a moment in the light. Bunky is a gracious man. He'll say, come on, minister, I would love to bless you. Don't pull the mantle off his shoulders. It's still his. Let's all stand, please. That's my teaching for